俄罗斯富豪遭遇灭门血案，而且还是连续两天分别在俄罗斯和西班牙出现，让人很难不产生联想。
I think these deaths in my book are very suspicious because they are so similar and they're both of prominent individuals who've made their money in the oil and gas sector.
首先是天然气工业银行的前总裁阿瓦耶夫，18号被发现他和妻女沉尸在莫斯科的豪华公寓里。没想到隔天，前天然气巨头纳瓦泰克的高阶主管托托申亚在西班牙租屋处上吊死亡，他的妻女也死于刀伤。
Avayev and Sergey Protasenya knew each other or communicated recently with each other.
They could be.Patterns of retaliation against individuals who may be collaborating with foreign authorities.
阿瓦耶夫现年51岁，虽然没有公开资产，却被俄罗斯媒体称为亿万富翁。至于波托申亚，曾是纳瓦泰克董事会的副主席，身家超过新台币125亿。两位富商都遭遇的灭门血案，也惊动了俄罗斯的上流精英们。
But it's definitely very important how.Two of those deaths could be perceived by Russian elites. A lot of people have an alternative in mind, to leave or to stay.
斯洋恩说，俄罗斯的精英阶级有人反对普京下令入侵乌克兰，因为国际制裁会影响他们的生意。只是专家也说，两位富商之死或许只是巧合而已。
State-owned corporations are.Probably could be a subject of Western sanctions, so everyone is nervous.
在这个时机点，又传出俄罗斯司法部将反对派人士穆尔扎列入外国代理人名单，显示俄罗斯当局加大力度打击异议分子。这个动作也让两位富商之死蒙上更深的谜团。TV 新闻综合报道，
请支持 TVBS 国际 Plus 全新频道，让您扩大视野，掌握趋势，接轨全世界。恳请订阅，开启小铃铛。